issues are a little iffy and off topic and don't match the Bible. For example, atheists. People don't believe in God.
More of the gospel. There's been more gospel centered, more God Poppy.
Cause Craig, you got his coffee. And how do you get his coffee? From the closet of the sun. And the effect is now he gets his coffee. After I finished printing things, I realized I like this, but I didn't put it down on your paper, on your programs. So I put it here, just from one side. The Westminster Confession of Faith. Yeah, it's a couple of things about what they believe. A long time ago, in 1600s, maybe 1646, there was an assembly of people got together and were discussing what they believe, because there was many heretics teaching and heresies, so they all came together and discussed what they believe, and they put it down into one book, summarized. It's basically what their faith was. So I found things I liked. So ignore the G, that was a mistake. There is only one living and true God who is infinite. So, forever, infinity, forward and backward. There's no stop. There's no beginning. It is eternal. Forever. In being pure spirit, invisible, so you can't see him, without parts or emotions, we'll discuss that later, unchangeable, he stays the same, we may change, we'll change our minds, we'll be influenced by many things, but he stays eternal, established forever, immensely vast, overwhelming, powerful. Everything that he does, he himself is incredible, eternal, beyond our full understanding. We can't understand him. Our brains are so limited in comparison. Almighty, completely wise. God is the Spirit. I already fixed it, but it didn't update. It didn't update the changes. Oops. Really, it's supposed to say God had full control. A lot of different things, but it's missing a whole bunch of it. At home on the computer was right, but when I transferred it to this lab, I thought it was good. What it means is that we believe that God is all these different things. churches all study this. I think it's about like 120 questions, something like that. I encourage you all to think about each question. We don't care. We know ourselves. All these different things, all different personalities. It's amazing that God created these. In the Bible side, I still believe in God, that there is one. I still believe in Jesus. And I support him, and I support the word of God. And no matter what other people already know. We feel it. We'll know that God is amazing. That he's the true God. We'll keep faith with him, no matter what may happen. Sometimes I may not understand. I don't fully understand. I won't understand what may happen. I may be upset, and I'll question why it may happen. But God has reason, and I trust him. Are they not all ministering spirits sent out to serve ministering spirits like angels? We don't see him. He comes to us. He is involved with us. We don't see him. We don't see him in anybody. Like Jesus, though. If we pray, an angel came and supported him. We'll have somebody with us. We have a spirit. We also have other spirits, too, that can come and protect us, lead us, help us, feed us, and minister to us. They're all other spirits. So, third point is that God himself is there. You know, many people don't understand it. Only Christians can understand. They know that God is like. But other people may say they believe in him, but they won't explain the same way. I have received not the spirit of the world, but the spirit who is from God. I mean, it's God's spirit. Comes involved with us. And we might understand the things freely given to us by God. So we'll be able to understand God with his spirit. We'll be able to understand what he does for us. For example, Evan's looking for a church that we wanted to move to before Seattle. But some people we had to pay, or it would be late in the afternoon, and it was a struggle. And he'd given up. And God used Dan, the pastor upstairs, you know? To contact us and meet with us. And then we ended up moving here. And became the center of the point for where our people could move to. It wasn't expensive. And also he supported us. And this was God's work. God led. And God made sure it happened. And I think that is incredible. And I understood. People might not understand. They're like, what do you want to be in this church for? It may be free, but that's okay. But they won't really think much about it. They won't understand. But I look at it and I think how amazing God is to have all this to work out.
And now, we as Christians, we understand how many other people who are not Christian don't. It says the natural person means there's no Jesus in their spirit, in their heart. There's no connection whatsoever. Does God accept the things of the Spirit of God? They don't accept them. We believe that he teaches and what he explains to us. They don't believe. They don't want to think about it. So I am myself, I live my own life. I am independent. Listen to you because they don't understand. Why do I have to go to church? It's worthless. I can just enjoy everything I have and be fine. Technology is what we live in that world. That's church. Everyone accepts me, we're all the same. I'm fine without God. Those people don't accept the word of God. Why, if there's no Jesus in their heart, that means they don't understand God at all. But they are folly to him. And the Word of God is the Word of the Bible is all. It's from forever ago. It's made up. It's not true. It doesn't mean anything.
and make up all these things and make it seem to vibrate. But that doesn't mean which way is the right way and which way is the wrong way. And you say, no, God wants them to do that. And no, God doesn't want them to do that. And they know to follow and obey God. Sometimes you wrong and you feel bad and you ask God to forgive you. But no, Spirit, they do wrong and use everything and they don't feel any guilt. They steal and they fine. They don't feel any guilt. And no, focus towards God. They like something that makes them feel better. It makes them feel comfortable. They prefer using that because they know that that is there for them. We should push that aside. See that God is with us always. That thing is not with you always. But God is with joy. He is with us always. We should trust. stand upon. You can vote like Jesus for that. Jesus himself, yes. He had a body and spirit, for example. But God, does he have a body and spirit? You would say yes, and some people may say no. He doesn't have hands or arms or have these different things in that category as a body. But our thinking is limited, so we don't really know exactly. There are a few verses that can paint us a picture that God has perhaps a body. In Joshua, the hand of the Lord. So he has hands. Okay. He has eyes. There's mentionings of different body parts. But we have a perfect image, exactly. So you can imagine that God may have a body, that he may have feelings, may have emotions, but that's not really correct. We can't put our views on that. We can't put our views on what God is. Can't do that. I feel awful, which means that God must also feel awful sometimes. If I'm happy, then it means that God must be feeling happy sometimes. We can't force that upon him. He's a different being.
When I was studying seminary, yeah. This was really interesting.
Material. It's like earthly things, like paper. Material, there's material like people, but there's also like material as in like a body. There's hands. There's bones. Hair. We have all these different things. Does God have them? No, not really. God, he created these different things. And that's it. But God built us. He gave us all these different things. He gave us eyes. He gave us a brain. He gave us a heart. He gave us hands and arms. He gave us all these different things. If we cut off our arm, it means we have no arm. If you cut off God's arm, does he still have an arm? Or does he have an arm at all in the first place? It's a little bit different between us and him. We on earth, with our brains, we can't imagine that we are exactly the same. We can die at any time. We can lose our self, body part. But God is infinite. It's impossible. Why? He is God.
I was studying this interesting, so I decided to put this in this beautiful sermon so you guys can remember it from this. So simplicity, which means to be simple, just get to the point. It's just God, that's it. It's not taught explicitly. Is inferred from God. For example, number one, being spirit. We can't divide spirit from God himself. It's two persons, but one God. His people can say, there's three gods, three spirits, and we split them all up. We have to shut aside, because God is God. There's three persons, but it's three in one. So it's equal to one God. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. And two roles, yes, but three of them are one God, not three gods. One God. Number two, unique. All connected. Suppose someone discreet, they're not God. Because God always is a unity. Three. Immutability. It means God is the same.
something to be not perfect is added to it. And you would be more accepting is not perfect. God is perfect in and of himself. God himself. He has all these things about himself that is perfect. And it's very hard for us to understand it completely about him. Stop, reach back to him. And know that he is always